students, welcome to the online session for the subject of industrial safety. These are the virtual classes for the subject of industrial safety. The subject of industrial safety is mainly for the students of civil engineering, particularly structural engineering and mechanical engineering. So here we will be discussing all the topics that are related to the subject of industrial safety. So now we will be starting with our session. So 3, 2, 1, let's go. Hello students, welcome to the online session for the subject of industrial safety. Today our topic is wear and corrosion and their prevention methods. So let's start with our session. First of all, we will see what are the topics that we are going to discuss today. So let's see the outlines. First is introduction to the wear, types of the wear, causes of the wear, and discussion to all types of wear. So these are all the topics that we are going to discuss today. So let's start with our session. That is the first, that is introduction to the wear. So let's start with the definition. So what is wear? Wear is nothing but the reduction in the shape and size of the machine parts because they are being used daily. So the definition is the reduction in the dimension in the parts that occurs slowly and continuously as a change in the shape and the surface of the finishing. So basically this is nothing but the reduction in the dimension and change in the dimension because of its daily usage. We all know that machines are being used daily in the industries. So there will be some wearing, there will be some modification that will be going to take place because of its daily usage. So that modification, the change in the shape and size and dimension because of its daily usage is termed as the wear. Now moving towards the next, let's see what is wear, how it occurs. So here in the first figure we can see that there is a coupling. So there the modification in the dimension and we can see that dimension has been changed. The modification on the surface has occurred because of the movement or because of the impression of the couplings on each other. So we can see the impression, the projections and some faults that has been found because of the wear. Similarly, in the next figure we can see that there is a pipe where the marks is been found on the surface, and this marks is nothing but the faults, the crevices that can be seen by the naked eye, and that is mainly taken because of the rotating or sliding or any other kind of the activities that has been occurred on these pipes. So yes, this is how the wear will looks in the actual life. Here the gear is there and gear is moving. So this is how the teeth are being moving with each other, and as a result of this there is a continuous contact of the teeth of the gear on one another, and as a result of this the wear will takes place, the surface will get abraded, the modification in the surface will takes place, and this is how the wear occurs because of the rotation and the sliding of the one surface over another. Moving towards the next, that is the types of wear. Wears are mainly divided into three types. The first is the molecular wear, second is the mechanical wear, and the third is the corrosive wear. So let's have a brief discussion on different types of wear. So let's start with the first, that is the mechanical wear. So mechanical wear are those wear which mainly takes place because of the movement of the machine parts. We can say that when the two surfaces either rotating or sliding on each another produce a friction. When the two surfaces are moving with each other, a friction will be caused because these two surfaces will be in contact with each other. The surface can be either any of the mechanical components. For example, gears. These are all the things where the mechanical wear used to takes place. So when the two surfaces which are in relative contact with each other and when they are moving, which they are having a motion, then as a result of this motion, the friction will be developed. And wear will be caused because of this friction. And the wear that is being caused because of such kind of friction is termed as the mechanical wear. Such kind of wears cannot be seen by a naked eye, but it can be found on the surface. So this is a property of a mechanical wear. the wear mainly increase because of the small particles that is being found on the surface of the object. So when the object is having some dust particles or any kind of a material, finite material on it, and as a result of this the mechanical wear can be caused. So this is how the mechanical wear takes place. So we can see some examples of such kind of wear, and the mainly the examples are nothing but wearing of the gear teeth. We have the videos of the gear teeth, we will be seeing in the next slide. Then next example is wearing of the shaft journals, bearings and the guides. Wearing of the belt and pulley while moving in a belt drive. Then wearing of the clutch and the lining. Then wearing of the key and the key groove. There is also another example like a chain drive. It is a universal example where the mechanical gear used to take place. So yes, in chain drive also the wearing used to take place. So this is how the gears are rotating in coming in contact with each other, and as a result of this the mechanical wear will occur. We can see the picture of the gears that is being rotating while coming in contact with each other. So this is how it's look. We have the video. So yes, this is how the gears are moving and they are coming in contact with each other. The teeth are coming in contact with each other, and as a result of this the mechanical wear will be formed between the on the surface of these teeth. Here, this is a belt on a motor, and where the belt is moving on the motor, and as a result of this the wearing of the surface of the belt will be found. So let's discuss the causes of the mechanical wear. So what are the causes? First is the when the friction that is being found between the two surface is the much reason for the occurrence of the mechanical wear. Next is the faulty design. If the design is having some fault, and that can cause the mechanical wear. Improper material is being utilized for the manufacturing of the machine, then it will not resist the required load, and ultimately the wear will take place. Misalignment of the parts. As we have seen earlier also, a video was there where the belt was moving on the pulley. So there, if the alignment is not proper, or you can say that if the alignment of the shaft and the trunnion is not proper, then as a result of this the mechanical wear can take place. Next is overloading on the parts. So when the machine is working, and if the design load has been reached, and though if the design load has reached, we are then also providing extra load on it, and as a result of this the wear on the machine can take place. Insufficient lubrication is provided. If proper lubrication are not being provided, then the mechanical wear of the machine can occur. So it is necessary to provide the regular lubrication. Maintenance and repair work is very much important to prevent the mechanical wear. So wearing machine should be maintained properly, and if necessary the repairing work should be done before only. So this was about the mechanical wear. Now moving towards the molecular wear. So molecular wear are mainly caused when the two surface it is in contact with each other, but here there is a relative motion and there is a relative pressure between the two surface. So when the two surface which is having a motion and which is having a high pressure will cause the molecular wear. The surface, because of the pressure, will get jammed, and as a result of this a localized welding will be caused, that is termed as the seizure, and this seizure will cause the wear on the surface, and such kind of wear is termed as the molecular wear. Yes, so this is how the molecular wear occurs. Now let's see what are the important terms that are in the molecular wear. So first term is the cohesive force. So when the two surface are in coming in contact with each other, which is in relative motion, will have a cohesive force. Means one surface will have a cohesive force on the another surface, and as a result of this, next term will occur. That is the penetration. So when the two surfaces in contact with each other and a cohesive force is developed, so because of that cohesive force, the penetration of the one surface over the another surface will occur. And because of this, the penetration will take place. And we all know that when the penetration takes place, then what happens? The third important term will happen, that is the impression. So when the penetration used to take place, then the impression will be found. And as a result of this, the weakening of the surface will take place. And as a result of this, when extra load will act on it, the breaking of the material will take place. And ultimately, the molecular wear will occur. Now let's see, what are the causes of the molecular wear? So the first cause is the parts that are being fitted are under high pressure, means the pressure acting on it, if it is higher than what it is designed, then there is a chances of the occurrence of the molecular wear. Next is the part that is coming in each other, that is rubbing with each other under high pressure and high velocity, can cause the molecular wear. Third is lubrication in the parts are insufficient. If the lubrication that has been provided, if they are insufficient, then as a result of this, the wearing takes place and molecular wear can occur. So the first example of the molecular wear is the railway track. We all know that wheels of the railway train is moving over these rails. As a result of this, there is a continuous effect and the cohesive force will be developed between the wheel and the rail, and ultimately the penetration of some extent will occur on the top surface of the wear because of the movement of the rail. We all know that rail is in motion also, it is having a velocity and it will be having an impact load on the rail, and ultimately the penetration will take place. And we all know that because of this continuous pressure of the wheel on the rail, the impression will be found, and ultimately the load taking capacity or the resistance capacity of the rail will get reduced. There is a chance of the breakage at some times. And next is, if the lubrication is not provided properly and though it is in action, then molecular will take place. Molecular wear will take place. The chances of the occurrence of the molecular wear because of the insufficient lubrication can occur. So this is how the molecular wear will occur. Now next is the corrosive wear. The name only suggests that the wear that has been found because of the corrosion is termed as the corrosive wear. We all know that metals that is being exposed to the environment and it is mainly reacting with the oxygen and the moisture that is being present in the atmosphere, and ultimately the metal will get oxidized. Here, because of this oxidation of the wear, a layer of the corrosion will be formed on the surface of the metal, and this makes the surface very soft. Because of this corrosive layer, the surface will get soft, and as a result of this, the surface will get brittle. So there is a chance of the breakage of the material when the corrosive layer has been found on the surface. And when such kind of corrosive layer is being found on the surface, we named it as a corrosive wear. So it has got softened, it has lost its strength, and whenever the load will be acting on it, it will break easily. So when such kind of breakage used to take place, we can say that the corrosion or the corrosive wear has occurred. And ultimately, we all know that the reduction in the dimension of the machine parts will take place. And if the reduction of the machine parts will occur, then the load taking capacity will also occur. It will become brittle, and ultimately, the breakage of the machine or the parts of the machine will take place. Let's see how it looks. So here it is a coupling where the corrosion have occurred and the total reduction in the strength have taken place, and whenever this will be in the reaction of working, at that time the wear will take place. The breakage of the overall part, machine parts will occur, and ultimately the breakage will occur. So this is how the corrosive wear looks actually. So this was today's our session. Thank you for attending the session. See you in the next session. Hello students, so hereby we are coming to the end of our virtual class session of the subject of industrial safety. We have discussed a lot regarding the topics of the today's session. So if you have any kind of a doubt, if you have any kind of queries, you can send me your doubts and queries via mail. My mail ID will be in my channel. So check into my channel, like it, and mail me whatever the doubts you have. And thanks again for attending the session. See you in the next session.